Hey everybody, Tim here with today's episode of Voyager, Season 2, Episode 18, Death Wish. I don't even know how to talk about this episode. So this episode, I've been waiting a long time, like since January 1st, to get to this episode. I even considered doing this episode live. This is probably, not necessarily 100%, but probably my favorite episode of all of Star Trek. And that's some big shoes to fill. So I'm sure some of you will disagree with me, and that's fine. This is just my opinion coming from me. But I love this episode, and I'm going to try not to get emotional talking about this episode. I've said before that I really hate politics. I do not like getting into politics because people get so worked up and so like blah, and I can't stand it. Like, I don't like it. And this episode is very like kind of political, but I love this episode, and I completely relate to this episode in a certain point of view, which I'll get to. I could be wrong. I would have to ask him, but I'm pretty sure this is the first episode that I ever showed my husband of Star Trek when we first met, we first got together. Because, like I've said before, I'm a huge Q fan. Like, John DeLancey is one of my favorite actors. Anytime he's at a convention near me, like, I get my picture with him and I have him sign stuff. I'm a huge Q fan. And I'm pretty sure after my husband and I got together, like, I got out my Q collection DVD set and had him watch this episode because I love this episode so much. Like, even little lines in it. So I'll kind of start from the beginning and work my way to the end. But to just do a summary of this episode, it's about Voyager encountering an asteroid, and they've never seen anything like it, and so they try to beam a core sample out, and it ends up being another Q, which, just to avoid the confusion, I'll call him Quinn. So there's Quinn and there's Q, that's John DeLancey's Q. And so Quinn comes aboard, and he is from the Continuum, and he wants to kill himself. And Q shows up and is basically like, no, you're not allowed to do that. And you've tried to do it before. So they locked him in this asteroid, this meteor. And the whole episode is Janeway basically being the jury on whether or not Quinn can have asylum on Voyager, or if he doesn't get it and goes back to his asteroid prison. So there are so many good lines where, especially after Q shows up and he's like, oh, look, there's a, like, no wonder Voyager is in the Delta Quadrant. Like, that's what happens when you put a woman in the captain's seat, which, like, the stuff like that would not fly today, but it's kind of funny. Like, it totally made me laugh. And it didn't even fly when this episode aired, because you can clearly see Janeway, like, roll her eyes and be like, seriously, like a woman driving joke. But it's funny because you see how outdated Q is and how in charge Janeway is. And then Q's immediately follow-up, where he sees that it's just the women on board because Quinn accidentally, like, got rid of them, of all of the men. And he's like, is this a ship of the Valkyries? And stuff like that. Like, I loved it. I thought it was really great. Quinn, whenever he does, like, John DeLancey's very well known for the snap, which, when I did those reviews, he doesn't do that until like season 3, whereas Quinn kind of does this, which is kind of funny because that's what Riker did. And then the female Q that we meet, where she's like, she doesn't know she's a Q, that's kind of what she does. So there's that. There's a lot of stuff about like how the Q are not like immortal. They're not I forgot what the word is, but they're not all forever being in whatever. So I really like those dialogues where it kind of, even Quinn brings up how like Voyager compared to like species that are not as advanced as they are, like, appear to be omnipotent. There's the word I was looking for. And Tuvok is like, yeah, you're kind of right. And it kind of goes back to, I think it was Arthur C. Clarke, where, paraphrasing, he says like, science that is beyond our comprehension is viewed as magic. And so that's basically what Quinn is saying, is he's like, we're not omnipotent. Like, we do have our own flaws and stuff. You are just not as evolved as we are, so we appear that way. He briefly brings up Vulcan ritual suicides, which Klingons have ritual suicides as well. So I think that was cool. When they start doing their juries and stuff like that, Q brings in three character witnesses to show how important Quinn is to society. One is Isaac Newton, who we've seen as a hologram before when Data was playing cards. One was a guy from Woodstock. And the other is Riker's. He brings in Riker because Quinn had met Riker's like great grand or one of Riker's descendants from like the Civil War or something. So this is now the third time John Franks has been in a different TV show, because he did have one appearance in Deep Space Nine as Thomas Riker, and then now he's in this one as Commander Riker. And so I thought that was kind of cool. I like how Q tries to bribe Janeway, where he's like, you know, we'll send you home if you like don't give Quinn back his do not side with Quinn and allow him to become mortal. I love the scene where they go to the continuum, and just, it's such a powerful scene when Quinn is making his case about how, like, this is my society. This is what the continuum's like, where people read magazines. They play the pinball game. Like, I was even the Scarecrow for a while, and Q was like, oh, we've all been the Scarecrow, and that's kind of fun. I like how Q shows up in bed with Janeway, which is kind of a throwback to the, what is it, Tapestry, where he's in bed with Picard. So there's that, and then now he's in bed with Janeway, which is kind of a foreshadow to when Q returns trying to, like, have a relationship with Janeway. But so much of this is so powerful. And I've got to say, so, like, I've gotten into philosophical debates with this before. I am very, like, okay with a euthanasia. I am, like, 100% on Quinn's side, where, like, he has explored the galaxy. He's read everything. He's done everything. And he even says, like, in my continuum, like, we used to have all of this dialogue, and you can hear it still going on. And Tuvok's like, I don't hear anything. And Quinn's like, that's because it's all been said. There's literally nothing left for us to do. And that's his... Janeway doesn't want to side with him because he's not sick. He doesn't have a disease that's going to kill him soon anyway, like cancer or something like that. And he's like, no, like, you don't understand. Like, you as an explorer, what if you'd explored everything and there's literally nothing else for you to do? Like, this is the disease. This is it, where he has a nothingness about him. And, like, that spoke to me on such a spiritual level that I completely related to Quinn, and I was like, I agree with him. And if he wants to be in control of his own life, and if he wants to take his own life, then that is his choice, and he should be allowed to pursue that. And especially when, like Janeway says, like, she's kind of stuck between a rock and a hard spot, where it's like, either he is denied that and he is forced to be part of the continuum and then locked into a meteor, or he is allowed to become a mortal where he will then kill himself. So it's either death or it's life imprisonment. And so it's like six one way, half a dozen to the other. And it's like, to me, like, between those two odds, like, suicide seems like the better choice between life imprisonment and just ending it, just being done. And it's such a powerful episode, and that's why I love this episode so much, and it's one of my favorite ones, because it really deals with those heavy, heavy topics of conversation. And, like, even the episode where Worf wants Riker to help him in assisted suicide, how I talked about in that episode, where, like, I agree with Worf, and that's his culture, and that was his right, his prerogative, that if he wanted to do it, he should be able to do it. And everybody says no, whereas if you go back and watch that review, I was like, I would have been that guy that was like, okay, you want this? I will be here for you. Quinn is the same way. Like, if I had been the captain and Quinn's like, this is what I want, I'd be like, even if I disagree, this is you and this is your choice, and I will stand behind you for this. And it's such a powerful episode. And what I love is how he talks about Q, and they don't shy away from Q. Like, Quinn even says, like, you were banned from the continuum because of the way you thought about things. And he was like, well, I've learned my lesson. And Quinn is like, that is the shame, because you are what made me think. You are what gave me inspiration. And now you're just like one of those. You sold out to the man, basically. And that's basically what kind of turns Q in, is because after they grant him asylum and Janeway does side with him, they it's kind of it's sad, but it's kind of funny, because for lack of a better word, where Janeway's like, we gave him a name and we're going to give him a position, and like from the very moment where she sided with him, I knew the first time I saw this episode, I was like, he's not going to survive. And you see Janeway talking to Chakotay, and she's like, well, let's do this and let's do that and let's give him like stellar cartography. And then sure enough, the doctor calls and he's like, Quinn's dying. And so Janeway rushes down there, and he ingested hemlock, which is a great powerful message in itself, because it goes all the way back to like Shakespearean times. And they start like, well, doctor, where did you get hemlock? Because you don't have it and the replicators won't do it. And sure enough, Q shows up and is like, I gave it to him because he deserves to get what he wants. And this is all, like, this is it. He had that empty feeling about himself, and this was the only way out for him. And I loved it so much. And I thought this was such a powerful episode. And it's such a good episode. If you guys have never seen this one, please look up this episode. I personally think it's great. I'm sure some of you are watching this, like, freaking out, yelling at your phone or your TV or whatever about how wrong I am. But I have to say, like, I completely agree with this episode. And I think Janeway made the right call. And I would have made the same knowing what Quinn's decision was going to be. Just, I agree. I think he did what he felt was right. So, for those who have seen this one, what did you think? Like I said, this is probably my favorite episode, not just of Voyager, but of Star Trek in general. Because it's so powerful. So go ahead, let me know what you guys think. What did you guys think about Quinn? I think he is now the third Q besides John DeLancey that we've seen, so I guess fourth total. So go ahead, let me know what you guys think about his character. Go ahead, let me know what you guys think about the whole situation. Try to be respectful. Let's not get into like mean debates or anything like that, because I would love to have an actual conversation about this. But knowing that opinions are very strong, kind of agree to disagree if you guys start to get overly angry or aggressive. So please go ahead, comment, let me know what you guys think. Thank you guys for subscribing, that means a lot to me, and I will see you guys next time for Life Signs.